Pedro the Portuguese immigrant.
Hello, my name is Pedro, and I'm a Portuguese man.
Yes,
from Portugal. And today I'm going to tell you my story. The story of how I got
to America!
But first, I think it's important that I talk a bit about myself so you can understand the story better. I was born March 13th, 1885. My parents gave me to an orphanage in Lisbon when I was just a little baby. And that was the place I spent the first 18 years of my life. The only thing I know about them is that they gave me a pocket watch. Other than that, their lives are a mystery to me. When I completed my 18 years, I started to study the law so I could become a lawyer. I passed most of my time studying. But then one day, I went to a club to meet new interesting people. And that is when I met Elizabeth. She was so beautiful, so we started dating. And time goes by and it's the year 1911. Me and Elizabeth were dating for 3 years. But what a fool I was! For 2 years she cheated on me with our ugly Brazilian doorman. So one day, I got to her place and I caught those two unholy sinners. She got mad at me because I got mad at her because she found me dull and started sleeping with the doorman. So I naturally argued like the gentleman I am. I would never scream at her. To this day, it remains a mystery to me how the hell there was a brick in her bedroom. But there was a brick in her bedroom, and she threw it in my head. She damaged my brain in a way that I shall never be able to know the translation to the word bacalhau in any other language. And that sucks, because how am I supposed to order it in other countries? Realizing she had to get some comeback, I went to her place in the middle of the night, and then I stole all of her daddy's girl British money. It was a lot of money. So naturally, having all that much money in my pockets, I wanted to move to a rich country. I wanted to reboot my life. And guess what? The land of the free called me one day embodied as a small word inside the only remain I had from my parents. So I hurried and bought myself a ticket in a boat to the United States of America, ready to set sail to the unknown. And do you think I bought myself a ticket in steerage class? Nope. I bought myself a ticket in the highest of classes. I was flaunting it. I had a lovely journey. I was so relaxed and filled with hope. That is, for the first day. That day they served nice food, but not what I was used to. I was missing my country's food. I was missing some sweet pastel de Belém, some lovely octopus, and most of all, some bacalhau! I hadn't eaten bacalhau for a full day. I was going insane. I started having hallucinations, seeing fishes in people's heads. I got mad. So we finally arrived at Ellis Island after 6 days of bacalhau-less hell. Other passengers commented upon the beauty of the Statue of Liberty, and she was indeed magnificent. Yeah. Hey, my man. Uh-huh. It's your boy, Bacalhau.
Sing it, man.
Do you miss me?
Say it.
Yes, I do.
When our enormous boat docked at Ellis Island's pier, everyone proceeded to exit it with happiness on their soul. However, I didn't. I had no soul anymore, so I vomited in a trash can and entered the building. They asked me a lot of weird questions, so of course I answered them all with a lot of sarcasm. And they didn't think it was funny when I marked this. I was interrogated by several police officers and released after a couple of hours. I waited in the Great Hall, confined for more 2 hours. I was starving to death.
They then called me to be released. I only needed to go through a medical examination that nobody bothered in telling me. So as I walk straight to my freedom, this man in a white jacket comes and looks under my eyelid. So I did what anybody would naturally do, and I punched him in the face. So the guards didn't like that, and then they tied my hands and put me in this Dying interrogation room again. And that's how I got here.
But hey, don't worry. I didn't tell them I stole an enormous quantity of money from my ex-girlfriend.
Did you just say you stole a large quantity of money from your ex-girlfriend? Normally you'd get deported, but we need working guys like you in our country, so... Oh man, but you're going to jail.
Cara, the...
Pedro de Português, imigrante.